Guys, how's it going? Well, looks like we're going to start a new project. I normally would do this project on my hydroponics channel, but YouTube is really coming down on those channels for anything. Like, I so much as post with anything about growing tomatoes or celery, they go nuts. So, I'm basically going to post most of these projects on this channel because it is basically electronics and everything else. And this is what the channel is all about. We're going to actually be reusing my wife's old case. I honestly have no use for it. So, what we're going to do is we're going to make a chiller. Something a little bit more portable. I mean, you can buy them like this, but it kind of takes the fun out of it when you have all the parts, right? The plan is to put a small rad in here for the hot side of the peltzer. And then we'll have that on the water block. We'll sandwich the peltzer in between the water block and another block for the cool side with an internal pump, which I've actually started here. Just waiting for the glue to dry. We'll have to test to make sure that's sealed up. But that'll go in there as well. And then it'll be all plumbed together. And then we'll build a plate on the back here. Seal these two off. And drill a hole here and here and have two bulb valves coming up the side, where you can turn off when you take it apart, push the hoses on and turn it on. And the power supply, since I do have probably about 50 different ones there, we'll pick the best one we can find, the highest wattage, and we will drop that in there as well. That way it is completely housed. All you have to do is plug the hoses on, power it on, and you're good to go. Be a nice, you know, it can sit beside the grow tent and it'll work just fine. And a little bit stylish too. But what we're going to do in this video is we're going to make sure we have all the parts to do this. So give me a minute and we'll see what we got here. We got the case. Obviously, you've already seen this. The pump we'll have to test. But if that works, that one there is a decent flow rate. But one thing it doesn't do is it doesn't actually heat the water up. I have a bigger one that's more expensive. But it's too big, and it would heat the water up, so that's no good. A rad. I know I got a rad laying around here somewhere. Oh, there's the pump I was playing with. That'll be for the hot side. But we're not going to use this plate. What we'll do is we'll put that on a water block, hopefully. We have a rad. A little rough, but that'll work. Okay, so we got a pump, we got a rad, hoses. I think I got some more black hose like this laying around. If you're wondering where that pump is from, that is one of the ones I had in my computer originally. I did a video on how to mod it. And there was the plates that I modded. And there's just the cover for it. The light. Sorry. But what I found with the ones on my computer is the large, long rads had a lot of corrosion in the pipes, so they were on their way out, and I decided to pull them out of the computer before they sprung a leak. Okay, so we got the water block. We need the water blocks. Where are they? We got more fans. It's probably this bottom. I got heat sinks here. I've been cleaning, which I don't normally do. So now everything is put away. Okay. I have a few heat sinks. All right. Some more water blocks in here from Projex. It's another one. Okay, we're not gonna need this for the hot side because we're going with the pump. We got these ones here. I could probably clean them out. They got a little bit of corrosion in them, but they do work. And then I got these ones here if we want to double up on the peltzers. I don't know if I should run one or two. I think you can only run one because if I run two, I won't be able to do the water block. Another one there. Yeah, that's all we should need. Alright, so we got water blocks. Another Peltzer. One doesn't work very well. I'm pretty sure I have more of them floating around here. Yeah, I'd have to find them. Anyway, hose. Give me a minute, let me find some hose. Pretty much got everything we need. I'm just going to quickly dab into these power supplies. Don't know what I got here. We'll have to make a jumper for it so it runs constantly. Doesn't matter what I'm going to do. I'll pull something down. Okay. Not too sure if this one works, but this one is a 300 watt? Wow. It's old. Might not be using that one. Let's see what else we got. This one is made by Delta. This is a says output, but doesn't give me the full power. 120, no, that's not it. 340 watts. But that's more of a server type PSU, so that might be our best bet. So we can find a decent 500 watt here. This one's off the 3D printer that died. This one's already pre-wired. This is our best bet. And I know this one works good. This is a 400 watt. It's designed for AMD processors. That's how old it is. This one's our best bet because this one's already pre-wired. It'll probably fire up right away. Ooh, but I removed... Why did I remove the power supply? I'll have to look into that. But I think this is our best bet. Screw these ones. Alright, what we'll do is, since we got the parts we need here, we'll do a part two, since it is a vlog. We've got more than enough here to make a decent chiller. Later, guys.